Hi everyone and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you three ways to insert a PDF document into your PowerPoint presentation. Since I'm presenting three different workflows here, you can find the timestamps in the description under this video so you can jump to the particular workflow that suits your needs. The first way is to add the pages of your PDF document to your presentation by converting the PDF document to the PowerPoint format and later inserting the needed pages inside your parent presentation. The second way is to insert the PDF document itself inside the PowerPoint presentation. So on one of your slides, you will have either a cover of the PDF document or simply an icon, and it's going to be clickable and you will be able to open this PDF document while in the slideshow mode. And the third way will work for you if you want to insert only one page of your document. And this is going to be inserting an image into your presentation. So let's jump right to the PowerPoint. And this is the presentation template that I'm using today. It's called Entorum, and this is the template perfect for business and corporate presentations. It features clean and modern design. It has a lot of charts and infographics that were created by professional designers. All of those are editable. The layouts look clean and very minimalistic, which is great for your presentation. And as you download this template, you get it in different screen dimensions, and you also get an archive package with the fonts used in the template. So if you're interested, go have a look at the Entorum product page on templatemonster.com. The link is also in the description. So the first way is to convert a PDF document into the PowerPoint format. And if you have an Adobe subscription, you can do that using the Adobe PDF Reader. But if you don't, there is a bunch of online services. It doesn't really matter which one you choose. You could just Google convert PDF to PowerPoint and you're going to find one of these. They're totally free, most of them. And you simply grab your document, your PDF document that you want to convert. You drop it on this website. And you wait until the process is finished, and then you can download this converted PDF document as a separate PowerPoint presentation. Once it is downloaded, it's gonna look like that, and you'll even be able to edit the individual elements on your pages. Now, if you want to select several pages, you can just click on the first slide in your selection, and then while holding shift, click on the last slide you want to select and choose copy. Then get back to the parent presentation in which you initially wanted to insert this PDF document. And then here in between the slides, you right click and you choose paste options. And this is how you insert the pages from your PDF document. So the quality is really good. The text is sharp. So if you use this way, the pages are not going to be blurry, they are not compressed, and the quality of the images will also be preserved. So now let's try and embed some PDF document into this presentation. Let me pick the right slide. Let's do this one, and let's say I want to embed a PDF document right here. Say I want the cover of the document. Let's say I'm going to be embedding an ebook to this document. And let's say I want the cover of this ebook to take up this area. And what I can do is just grab and drag it on top of this page in the PowerPoint. This is probably the easiest way and the most intuitive. This is how you're used to doing things. You just drag and drop the document right here. So this is what it would look like. If I double click on it, it opens the document. And here you can view your document. Another way to do it is to go to Insert, find the object, create from file, and click Browse and select the needed PDF document in your Explorer. And if you do it this way, you get a lot more options to choose from. You can either use the link feature here, you have the explanation down below, and you can either embed the cover of the PDF document as we did, you know, just dragging and dropping it onto the slide, or you can display this document as an icon and it's going to look like this. And you can also pick another icon. So it's just going to look like a normal document icon that you have in your Explorer. So not a cover of the document, but this little thing. So you can simply drop it somewhere, and you can also open that PDF document clicking on this icon. So object, create from file, browse, pick the document, and click OK. But now, while actually showing the slides, previewing them right here, you do not have the option to click on this document and open it. In order to enable this option, we're going to add an action to this cover. Right, let's click on it again, make sure it's selected, go to insert, here find the action. Then choose either mouse click or mouse over. Mouse over will just mean that you'll need to hover over this image here in order to trigger the action. And on mouse click, select object action open and click OK. This makes this image, this document, let's call it that, clickable once we open it in a slideshow. Like that. As you see now, my cursor is a pointer, and once I click, it opens the PDF document in a reader. So once you do it this way, this PDF document becomes a part of your presentation. But if you want to keep it as a separate document and only insert a link to it into your slide, let's go to Insert Object, then select the PDF document in your Explorer and check this box. This is going to mean that the PDF is going to stay as a separate document, and all of the changes that you make to this document are also going to show once you follow the link from your presentation to this document. But still, in order to make it clickable, you will need to add an action or a hyperlink. We could also do it using a hyperlink. But doing it using the action feature is a lot easier and faster. So for now, this document is clickable and we can open it in the Adobe Acrobat Reader. If you're using Mac OS in order to create your PowerPoint presentation and you want to insert a PDF document in one of the slides, the workflow is going to be a little bit different. Here you can simply grab this PDF document from your Finder and just drop it anywhere on your page. But using actions, you're not able to open this document, so we're going to simply create a hyperlink that is going to forward the user right to the PDF document. Keep this image selected, go to Insert, choose Action, Hyperlink to Other File. Then in the Finder, find the needed PDF document, click OK. And now while showing your slides, you're going to be able to click on this image and open your PDF file right from your slideshow. Now let's see how we can embed only a part of a PDF document. To do that, you're first gonna need to take a screenshot of the page that you want to insert. Go and open your PDF document. Depending on the PDF reader that you are using, the workflows and the way to access the screenshot tool might look a little different. But I'm using Adobe Acrobat Reader, so I simply need to go to Edit and choose Take a Snapshot. Then I'll need to make my page smaller. Then pick the right position. Select the area that I want to capture while still holding the mouse button, and then release, and it is going to automatically save this area as a picture to your clipboard. Now back in the PowerPoint, simply press Ctrl V or go to Home, Paste, and there you have your page. And if you want to capture the entire page of your PDF document, double click on the page and it is going to take a snapshot of it. back in the PowerPoint, just press Ctrl V, and this is how you can paste this page into your presentation. So you have learned how you can embed a PDF document into your PowerPoint presentation. By the way, if you need a good looking and customizable PowerPoint template, check out the collection of PowerPoint templates on templatemonster.com. These are created by professional designers, and here you will definitely find something that will suit your presentation purpose. Or in case you need to buy PowerPoint templates in bulk, check out One Subscription by TemplateMonster. One Subscription not only offers PowerPoint presentations, it also has a wide range of other products for website building, such as themes, plugins for various platforms and various business niches. If you're interested, check out the links in the description down below. And this is pretty much it for this tutorial. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you liked this video. If you did, don't forget to leave us your thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to not miss new tutorials.